this is Claudia here from the Bookkeeping Experts. I've been a bookkeeper for a long time, accountant. I have a master's in accounting, so I have the accounting background and bookkeeping and the technological aspect as well. Absolutely love integration because I think that's exactly how the world is going. So in order for you to optimize your time, you will need to use technology. You will need to use integration. And today we're going to talk about integration, Shopify and PayPal. So we talked about Shopify before, Shopify integration with QuickBooks. Today we're going to talk about when PayPal is integrated into Shopify and then Shopify is integrated into QuickBooks. So in the past, those transactions were not coming from Shopify. So you had to have PayPal integrated into QuickBooks as well so you could accept those income transactions and work with PayPal. Since July, there was a recent update. And what happened? Now those transactions, cash transactions, PayPal, other transactions, other payment transactions that are connected or integrated into Shopify are now coming through QuickBooks. And if you have PayPal integrated as well as Shopify, what's happening is that you're duplicating your sales. You don't want to do that. So what you got to do is get rid of PayPal. So you got to clear all transactions from PayPal and just work with Shopify. Okay, so we're going to go over how it's working, how the integration, and we're going to talk about how to set up the integration as well. So wanted to mention to you that the majority of the people who watch our channel are not subscribed. So one way for you to support our channel so we can keep bringing those information for you is to click the button on subscribe down below. Give us a thumbs up. That's something so simple, but it helps us so much. And if you do that, we'll keep bringing content that is very relevant and updated so you can use your QuickBooks Online in the easiest way possible. This is free tutorial. You don't have to pay anybody to train you. To you every week, you want to stay up to date so you can stay on top of your finances. All right, subscribe. And here we go. We're going to go straight to our presentation. And then we're going to jump to a QuickBooks account, simple account. Okay. So Shopify and PayPal integration with QuickBooks Online. That's what we were talking about, right? Okay, so here is what it looks like when you look at the chart of accounts. So if you're clicking on transactions on the left-hand side menu, then go to chart of accounts, this is what you're going to see. It works like undeposited funds, right? Because the deposit, all the sales are deposited on these clearing accounts. So for all the Shopify accounts that are booked or paid straight with credit card, it's going to go to your regular clearing account. And for those paid with PayPal, it's going to go straight to your PayPal clearing account. There's a few differences on how those transactions will be recorded. We're going to talk about that right now. So sales transactions will be recorded in the clearing account. Okay, for Shopify transactions, sales transactions are deposited and the transactions deposited from Shopify will be recorded as a transfer to your checking account. For PayPal transaction sales will also be recorded on the PayPal clearing account, but deposits are going to be deposited straight to the checking account and you will need to categorize them as transfer, not sales. So for the Shopify credit card, you will match in banking. Okay, for the PayPal one, you will categorize as a transfer. You bet match it on banking because a transfer will be automatically recorded for the regular credit card Shopify transaction, not for the PayPal ones, okay? Because PayPal transactions will be deposited straight from PayPal, not Shopify. So that's why you will need to record or categorize those transactions as transfer, and for the PayPal, not matching, for Shopify, must match. Okay, so the balance on the clearing accounts will need to be zero after all transactions are cleared. except if there is a one or two or three transactions or a few sometimes that doesn't clear until the next billing cycle or the next accounting month. So let's suppose that you had a sale on the 31st of October, but the money didn't hit the account until the 1st of November. So you will see the clearing account with the balance if you're pulling up the report for October. So it's good to know. But those should be only the transactions that clear the following month. So that's important to know. Okay, to see those transactions in QuickBooks, so you're gonna click on the transactions and then add transactions. And then first, the workflow is to add those transactions from add transactions first, and then you match it in banking if it is credit card. Okay, so you will click on add or you will confirm. And then on the other side, you're gonna go to the bank transactions and match those transactions, okay? All right, so we're gonna end the slideshow right now and we are going straight to QuickBooks now, okay? We'll maximize this so you can see it. And this is a sample account, so it's not directly connected to Shopify. So if you're not linked yet, in order to link your Shopify, you're gonna click on the app tab on the left-hand side and click on find apps. And then you're gonna type Shopify, but mine is already there, right here. And it's gonna be the one that says Shopify Connector by QuickBooks. This one is free, okay? There's other integrations out there. We're talking about this one, Shopify Connector by QuickBooks. This one is free and it's working pretty good right now. It's been updated. So to connect, you would just select the Shopify Connector and then click on Get App Now. When you click on Get App, you will need to log into your account. And it's very important to map it correctly. When people talk about mapping, what is mapping? So mapping basically means that when you are selecting the accounts that will be integrated in Shopify, you need to select the correct account. So if it's going to your checking account, you will need to select checking account. You want the lump sum transactions, go through very carefully with the integration. We have a video on that with more details. We'll put a link there. But very important to be very careful here for integrating to map it correctly. All right, so after is mapped, what you're gonna see, oh yes, you can also integrate through here, transactions, app transactions. Those are all integrations done by QuickBooks and it's gonna be all in here. You can connect free app right here. It's the same thing. Okay, all right. So after it's integrated, you saw how it works. You saw that you will go to transactions and app transaction and you see the transactions in here. And you're gonna add here first and then match it in banking. Once again, this is a sample account, so it doesn't work the same way. But I wanted to show you how on the chart accounts, you will see, oh yeah, by the way, it's not a bank, this is an asset account. So I will need to update that. So this should be an other asset. Okay, so let me select the other asset. Other current asset. And there you go. All right. All right, so it's just that I have sub accounts. But anyhow, this should be an asset account and it will record it correctly when you integrate, okay? This is just created like that. If it has sub accounts, it's not gonna let me change anything. It will, but I'll have to undo the links first and we don't wanna do that. But I just wanted to show you how it looks like. And if I click on View Register, you're gonna see all the income and expense. So now this is very important for you to see because this is the deposit into the Shopify account and this is the expense for the Shopify fee and this is the transfer recorded into the Chase account or whatever checking account that you are depositing the sale. Same thing here. See that? So you see the deposit, You see the expense related to the Shopify fees and the deposit that will be recorded as a transfer to your bank account. And then you will need to match it, because if you don't match it, you will be duplicating your sales. Now, I wanted to show you what happens with the Shopify PayPal account. So we're going to click on View Register and see that it only has this transaction over here, which is the sales transaction. And what you're going to see in the account is only the deposit coming from PayPal. So you're going to go ahead and click on the Chase account. This is the deposit. It's going to say PayPal deposit, okay? And what I'm going to do is I'm not going to name this sales a product, because this sale is already recorded. I'm going to record it as a transfer. And I'm going to transfer into the clearing PayPal, not to the other clearing, not to the channel clearing account, which is a parent account, not to the regular clearing account. I want the clearing PayPal, okay? So that should have only the PayPal account here, because the other one will be matched to a transaction already. Anything that is paid directly through Shopify, you will have that transfer already recorded. As I add this transaction here, and I'm going to go back here, transaction, chart of accounts, and we're going to go to the PayPal. Now you're going to see the deposit and the transfer out of the PayPal clearing account going into your checking account. So that's how it works. And at the end of the day, you want to have zero balance on both accounts. And that's exactly what we have here, okay? Except that it's not a bank. Like I said, it's an asset account, but it was created as a bank incorrectly. It is an asset. It works like the same thing, but you don't want to create a bunch of bank accounts, because this works like undeposited funds, right? It's just holding your money in there until it is recorded to the proper checking account. So that would be it. We're going to talk a little bit more about how to reconcile those accounts. You will need to have the Shopify reports for that. And you want not only reconcile regular checking account, but you also want to reconcile your clearance account, just to make sure that all the transactions are there, okay? And you will be able to see that with the Shopify reports. When you are looking at your reports, look at your profit and loss. And one thing you want to make sure, like I said, you want to make sure that the sales are recorded correctly. Whatever sales is for Shopify is there, and whatever is for PayPal is there. And you also want to see all the fees, Shopify fees, PayPal fees. And sometimes what you will need to do when there is PayPal as well is to record, at the end of the day, record the PayPal fees, because sometimes what is deposited in your bank is the net payment, and what is recorded as a sale is your gross sales. So that's not recording automatically your PayPal fees. And at the end of the day, you'll see a balance on the account that is supposed to be PayPal fees. What you can do is just record an expense. So you're going to do the plus new, and you're going to create an expense. Okay, so you're going to say PayPal. And you're going to select the payment account as that PayPal clearing account. Very important, okay? And then you're going to select PayPal fee and whatever amount that fee is. And that is going to deduct that balance. Like I said, you're expensing it to that PayPal clearing account, because that's where you want to put that fee, because the fee has been charged by PayPal, right? Okay, all right, we're going to stop here. Let's go back. Okay, hopefully this was useful to you. I know that this is a nightmare to many people, especially after the update in July. Oh my goodness, There are so many possible errors out there. You want to make sure you don't duplicate your accounts. You want to make sure you reconcile those clearing accounts, those assets, the clearing accounts for Shopify and PayPal. For the PayPal account, you will need to use both your Shopify reports as well as your PayPal accounts, because PayPal will have all your fees. Shopify doesn't have your PayPal fees, but PayPal does. So you want to look for that information in PayPal reports. All right, so hopefully this was useful. And I want to see you back again next week. Like I said, if you have not subscribed yet, make sure you click on that button, subscribe. And I'll be back next week. We're bringing 2 videos a week right now. We're going to talk about many other softwares, even different accounting software. I use QuickBooks because of the integration features, and also it's very used to use for a small and medium company. It's absolutely excellent. There are some flaws. Yes, there are some flaws out there. And the integrations, yes, they're not perfect. It's getting better and better. We expect that to get to a point where it's a lot more like an ERP system, but on a smaller scale. And that's exactly what they're trying to do. So where you integrate different features into QuickBooks Online to make it more robust. Okay, so one thing that we saw at the conference was a few things. If you have an e-business, that keeping up with sales tax is really a nightmare. You can say that again and again. It is a true nightmare. You want to keep up with your nexus whenever your sales tax is reaching that amount where you have to start filing taxes on different states, and you have to register with those states, and you have to file every month with all those states, or every quarter depending on the states. And there are all kinds of rules on each state, so you want to make sure you make this as easy as possible. So there's a couple of affiliates that we use. One of them is Avalara, is very good. And also integration with inventory. Inventory can be a complete nightmare. I'm serious, complete nightmare. If you use QuickBooks for inventory, I would say no, don't do that. That is not the best, unfortunately. You will need to use a third-party inventory app to manage your inventory and integrate it with QuickBooks. A very good one that I found, once again, on QuickBooks Connect, I am an affiliate with them and I use their products, is Settle. Now, for you guys who buy a lot of inventory, you probably need to buy it, let's say, in the middle of the year when the money is not coming, because you need to get enough supply for November, December, for Christmas time, right? And that money is not coming. What Settle does is not only helping you with your inventory management, but they also help you with the financing of that inventory. So if you need like a fast financing, they're going to help you out with that. They don't only do that, but they also do accounts payable. It's all in one place. I am an affiliate with those two, but I also believe in the product. I use the product. I believe in the product. And I think that for you guys out there who want to grow, you want to use all the features available that will make your life easier so you can be more productive. Because if you're not using all the technology available out there, you will fall behind, and you don't want to fall behind. So you want to stay on top of your game because you want to take your business to the next level. You want to continue growing, and that's how you do it. Okay? I hope to see you next time. And until next time, keep on smiling.